Man, we're the generation we can't afford to wait.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Could you all please stand for the national anthem, please? God's blessings, and this will be done by Mr. Jomo Butler, Acting Deputy Comptroller of Customs.
Can we kindly rise again as we ask God's blessings on this afternoon's proceedings? Let us bow in prayer. Blessed God and eternal Heavenly Father, we declare once again how good is the God we adore, our faithful, unchangeable friend. Father in God, we thank thee indeed for what thou hast done in bringing this course to this point wherein we can now come together in this manner and recognize the work that has been done and those who have labored. We thank thee for the students. We know that it was difficult times. And we can say at times weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. We ask, Father in God, now thy blessings upon today's proceedings. We ask that thou be glorified in all that is said and done. And that even as they would during this time celebrate their completion, that they may recognize it's now time for them to put into application in a practical manner that which they have learned in the classroom. We ask that thou would bless them, cause that they may be an asset to this federation, an asset to Munstrat as well. And we ask indeed, O God, that thou will watch over this proceedings. Have thine own way. As we ask these things in Jesus' precious name, give thee thanks. Amen. Amen.
Deputy Financial Secretaries, Mrs. Sylvia Gums and Mr. Calvin Edwards, Chief Personal Officer, in the Human Resource Department, Mrs. Tofrida Rochester, Permanent Secretary, Acting in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Aviation, Ms. Kebas, Comptroller of Customs, Acting Mr. Kennedy De Silva, and management team, Ms. Lanlia Archibald and Mr. Jomo Butler. Farrell Smithen, President of the Nevis Island Assembly. Deputy Comptroller of Customs, retired Major Colonel Kelly. Assistant Comptroller of Customs, retired Mr. Theodore Brown. Assistant Commissioner of Police, retired Mr. Joseph Richardson. Assistant Comptrollers in the Nevis Island Division, Mr. Roger Fifield and Ms. Wendy Wilkes. Members of the media, course participants, other invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It is my great pleasure today to welcome you to the 12th edition of the Caribbean Customs Law Enforcement Council Junior Officers Basic Training Course Graduation Ceremony. Class of 2018, you have long anticipated this day, some with eagerness, some with anxiety, some with joy and happy it's finally over, and some with a complex mix of emotions. But however you may feel, just know you have made it. And I say congratulations to you all. I know all who are gathered here today to celebrate with you have confidence in your abilities to go back to your respective areas of work and put what you have learned on this training course to good use. Course participants, graduation is about endings and beginnings, a celebration of a transition to a different chapter in your lives as young, productive, responsible adults and customs officers. Hence, on behalf of the graduating class of 2018, I would like to express sincere appreciation and gratitude to all those who have helped in one way or another in making this training course a success. Finally, I wish all the participants every success, happiness, and prosperity for the future. Again, congratulations and welcome. It is now my humble and pleasant duty to welcome the training coordinator of this year's course, Mrs. Diane Henderson Phipps, to give the course overview. Please welcome Ms. Henderson.
I am Diane Henderson Phipps. I'm a functioning senior customs officer, grade 4, and I'm presently assigned to the training unit. Please allow me to adopt the protocol that has already been so ably established here today. I speak today on behalf of Mr. Kennedy De Silva, Acting Comptroller of Customs, Mr. Jomo Butler, Acting Deputy Comptroller of Customs, with responsibility for human resource and training, other senior members of management and staff. The senior management of the Customs and Excise Department has always envisioned the development and empowerment of our junior officers as paramount. Thus, the 12th Caribbean Customs Law Enforcement Council Junior Officer Basic Course, better known as the Job Course, opened on Monday, 29th January, 2018. In attendance were 28 junior officers, 2 officers from Her Majesty's Customs Montserrat, 6 officers from our Nevis Division, and 20 officers from St. Kitts. The principal objectives of this undertaking were to impart customs knowledge through information and to create a learning environment that demonstrates techniques which will enable our junior officers to improve their ability to handle challenges in practical customs situations. Immediately after the opening ceremony, the pretest was administered. This would test the knowledge of the participants. The results, by tradition, has always been greatly anticipated, as history has shown the disparity between pretest and final scores. However, we are pleased to inform that Ms. Peaches Powell scored highest on the pretest, her score being 34.5%. Let's give her a round of applause. Weeks 1 and 2, the participants were exposed to topics such as legislation, where they were sensitized to the Customs Act number 19 of 2014. This is the legislative framework on which officers perform their duties. The officers were very keen on learning the scope of their powers, which included power to carry out search of person and cargo, and also the power to question traveler and importer as outlined in the Act. The presentation of other topics such as situation diffusion further heightened the officers' interest as they participated in role plays which highlighted the importance of an officer's quick thinking and their ability to control and avoid the escalation of incidents that may occur during their performance. Other topics covered were overview of customs, prohibited and restricted goods, communication and tariff classification. Weeks 3 and 4 proved to be quite interesting as the officers were highly engaged during the presentations of topics such as risk assessment, selecting, targeting, traveler and cargo. During these sessions, the participants were taught how to identify verbal and nonverbal behaviors, documentary and physical indicators relative to the processing of traveler and the clearing of cargo. As the days progressed, the officers continued with sessions such as tariff preferences and invoicing. Passenger and baggage search, however, became the highlight of that week. The facilitators presented pictorials of concealment methods which offenders would use to transport illegal drugs, weapons, and ammunition. This had an impact on the students, as some of them were seeing for the first time the level of thought that goes into the efforts to defraud customs. Week 4 concluded with vessel search practical at the Coast Guard facility. I would mildly put it, this exercise proved to be a challenge for the officers. But with great tenacity, they were able to overcome and was indeed ready for post-test 4 the following Monday. Weeks 5 and 6 came along, and the depletion of energy was evident. Nonetheless, we journeyed on with our external facilitators and partners from the Department of Agriculture, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and the Ministry of International Trade. As they presented on topics, planned quarantine and toxic chemicals, diplomatic and consular rights and privileges, trade facilitation, and the role of customs. These presentations were equally informative. Other topics covered were criminal investigation awareness, the role of customs in border security, container search, and integrity. The presentation of these topics brought a realization of the importance of the role and function of customs in protecting our borders. As the facilitators reinforced with group work and practical exercises, the need for officers to develop and practice proper search and interviewing techniques. The final days were upon us, weeks 7 and 8. The march was slow but steady, as the students were engaged in presentations and demonstrations on our current electronic tool, Asecura World, which is an automated system used to collect customs data. The week concluded with sessions that would prepare the participants for practical rifle range on Friday, March 16th, and final exam slated for Monday, March 19th. Post-test 1 saw Mr. Quaisant Edwards distinguish himself when he pulled ahead of the class, earning 77.3%. Officer Edwards, I'll ask you to stand. So, can I identify Quaisant Edwards? Thank you. Hostess 2, Ms. Peaches Powell, emerged with the top score of 86.4. Stand, Ms. Powell. Hostess 3, Officer Powell continued her reign as she earned her highest score yet at 91%. We were on to Hostess 4. It was Ms. Peaches Powell again in top spot as she scored 78.8%. The last Hostess was administered on Monday, March 5th, and we saw Officer Quaisant once again regain his spot with an outstanding performance where he achieved the highest score of all the Hostess, and that was 93.6. Top four performances in final exam, and we have a top four because we have a two-way tie at second place, and the results were as follows. Third highest score, final exam, goes to Sharika Chapman, Nevis Division. The two-way tie, highest scores, Officer Asiya Smitten, Nevis Division. Sorry, Sharika's score, 84%, Smitten, 88%. Officer Quaisant Edwards joined the tie at 88%. Top score and final exam goes to Officer Peaches Powell of St. Kitts. Scoring 95%, this being the highest score of them all. Overall, top three performances, placing third, Officer Sharika Chapman, Nevis Division, 80%. Placing second, Officer Quaisant Edwards, St. Kitts, 82%. The best overall performance goes to Officer Peaches Powell of St. Kitts, 86%. In closing, I'm looking around to see if Mr. Renford is here. Somebody could tell me. Whoever. In closing, I would really like to mention at this time Officer Ivor Renford, Customs Officer Grade 4, and my colleague in training. I can stand here and say that we've stood side by side, shoulder to shoulder for 8 weeks. We've had challenges, we've had moments of weakness. We've had doubts, however, we never missed a day. Today, I would like to acknowledge on behalf of Mr. Kennedy De Silva, our acting comptroller, and Mr. Jomo Butler, acting deputy comptroller of customs, to speak of the unwavering support from the Honorable Prime Minister, Dr. Timothy Harris, Minister of Finance, and the senior officials in the Ministry of Finance. Mrs. Hilary Hazel, Financial Secretary, Mr. Calvin Edwards, Deputy Financial Secretary, Mrs. Sylvia Gomes, Deputy Financial Secretary, Mrs. Sherilyn Pemberton, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Finance, Mrs. Tofrida Rochester, our Chief Personnel Officer in the Human Resource Department. We can't overstate and we can't express enough the gratitude for your continued partnership and financial investments in such training as this. Let's give them a round of applause. We also use this opportunity to highlight the partnership and contribution of our external facilitators. They come with us year after year, and we say thank you. We must at this time also acknowledge our hardworking and dedicated in-house facilitators, whose wealth of knowledge, experience, and skills combined have made this cyclic course a success. A number of persons went above and beyond to ensure a successful training product. We recognize their contribution at this time. Mr. Kennedy De Silva, our acting comptroller, indeed sacrificed his Saturdays and came here to be with the participants. Let's give him a round of applause. Mr. Jomo Butler, acting deputy comptroller of customs, who I am certain I have called about 2,000 times since this course began. He's responsible for the training unit. He went above and beyond with this training course, and we really felt the support in the training unit. Let's give him a round of applause. Miss Lonnie Archibald, senior assistant comptroller of customs, who supported and came up the steps to make sure that we were all right. Mr. Reginald Walters, Mr. Marvin Duport, who was one also who came on Saturdays to reinforce with the students their studies. Mr. Joseph Richardson, who is now assigned to us here at Customs, one of our very own. He's an assistant commissioner of police, retired, and he's been with us also. Let's give him a round of applause. Mr. Desley Greenaway, Mr. Jevon Gums, Mr. Brian Mills, Mr. Nashon Maynard, and Sergeant Sherwin Julius and company from the Coast Guard. It's an honor at this time to recognize the presence of Mr. Theodore Brown, who's still one of us, retired Assistant Comptroller of Customs, who has dedicated a number of years in our training department. We recognize him this afternoon. Also, Major Retired Deputy Comptroller of Customs, Cornell Kelly, for his contribution in our Human Resource Department. We recognize and thank you, sir. And now, we're on to our dear participants. When this CICLET course started, and we realized that you were the group that was selected, indeed we looked and we said that you're a young group. But I can stand here this afternoon and say, even though you're young, you're worth your salt, as we would say. You have stood the test of time. You came very green, as some would express that you were green, but you stood. You stood the challenges. You rise above. We need to give you a round of applause. You have now been exposed to a vast amount of information. You should now be in a better place to further impact this organization. We have stood by you for 8 weeks. We've seen your highs and your lows. Nonetheless, I say again, you stood. It is now time for you to navigate your path and make sure you navigate it forward. Your learning continues. I will certainly miss you. I will miss coming up the steps at mornings. And as you know, good morning, participants. Good morning, participants.
Good morning, Mistress.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
This
is the day that the Lord has made. Very well. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Henderson Phipps, for the very short, in-depth course overview. I now call on my good boss, Mr. Kennedy De Silva, Comptroller of Customs Acting, to deliver the Comptroller's address.
Good afternoon, everyone. I seek your indulgence in allowing me to adopt the protocol already established. I wish to take this time to welcome everyone to this closing ceremony and express our sincere gratitude that you have taken time out of your busy schedule here today to celebrate the achievements of our young officers. I'm sure that the course participants are delighted to have you here today in their moment of glory and triumph. I believe there are also family members and close friends among the crowd who are pleased to see the participants here, ready to receive their certificates. To you, I say a very special welcome. There are also others who are among the crowd who have helped to make this training a success, from its budgetary support, to giving up their valuable time and delivering lectures, or in some capacity, help with our logistic assistance that we needed for this course to be a success. I wish not only to welcome you here today, but I want to express profound gratefulness for your support. It has been a grueling 8 weeks, and they have done approximately 320 hours of training. They would have studied every evening, and in some cases, whatever they learned on the Friday afternoon, they would get it on the test Monday morning, bright and early. This was compounded with take-home assignments which they had to complete. And I just wish to say here that Nash and Jomo, you guys won't appreciate it for doing that. Hear the laughter? There have also been some casualties. We've had sprained ankles and wrists. Laughter again. Some hurt shoulders from the weapons range. Visits to the hospital. There have even been some members who were tossed overboard at the Coast Guard for failure to keep the hostel crewmen in check. So yes, there have been a rough 8 weeks. But fear not, I have some good news. There'll be no training for the next 2 weeks. I can't vouch for April. I've heard Jomo discussing quietly something about some new SOPs and some scanner and something and everything. So I can assure you that you'll have 2 weeks off, but I can't speak for April going forward. But it's been a long day, so I will not bore our guests. I know we want to get on with it. So I believe in saying more with fewer words. So I'll wrap up with a few words to the class of 2018. There's been a lot of financial and human resources made available to you over these last 8 weeks. This means that we've laid the foundation for you to become better at warehousing, decoration processing, risk management, better investigative officers, more prepared to be able-bodied seamen, competent rummage personnel, and generally better enforcement officers. So, with all of that that's done, management expects to see a return on its investment. Actually, we demand it. So starting next week, I expect to see some real drive coming out of the respective stations in which you'll be assigned. I expect to see more questioning of the rules and not just blind complacency. I expect a higher detection of threats, whether they be fiscal in nature or illegal importation, and better facilitation of legitimate trade. Then there's the issue of integrity and compromising friendships. The nation can ill afford officers who are undecided or have conflicting loyalties. So, the choice is simple. Pick a team, choose a side before one is chosen for you. I believe you have some inclination in the way senior management feels on this issue, so do not run afoul of these sentiments. Finally, to end on a positive note, I wish to congratulate the participants on the completion of the course, and I hope that you've established mutually beneficial friendships, friendships that would add value to your personal and professional lives. This is a changing organization, and we must adapt to it. There are needs that are required in the 21st century. And I hope, like me and the management team, you will enjoy tomorrow. Once again, congratulations and good luck, class of 2018.
I now call on the newest member of the valedictorian fraternity, Mrs. Peaches Powell, to give the class valedictory address. Welcome, Peaches.
The legendary Martin Luther King Jr. remarks, and I quote, "All labor that uplifts humanity has dignity and importance and should be undertaken with painstaking excellence." End of quote. Good evening, everyone. Allow me to adopt the protocol that has already been established. It is against this backdrop that I, on behalf of my fellow graduates, humbly welcome you with much appreciation and enthusiasm to the 12th Cichlet Commence Ceremony, which is designed to celebrate our show of excellence. Mrs. Phipps, please raise this for me. This is
the day that the Lord has made. This is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Firstly, I would like to thank God for giving me this opportunity to speak this evening. If it had not been for God, I would not be here right now. For He is the one who has given me the strength and courage to press on, both academically and spiritually. Through the 8 weeks of the 12th Caribbean Customs Law Enforcement Council course, especially in times of discouragement. We have to be thankful for, at the St. Kitts and Nevis Customs and Excise Department, where we have received a great education. Thanks to our Acting Comptroller, Mr. Kennedy De Silva, Acting Deputy Comptroller, Mr. Joma Butler, who is responsible for human resource and training, as well as the other members of the senior management staff, for selecting all 28 officers of the graduating class to participate in this course. Ms. Phipps, by way of information, great appreciation is also extended to the training unit coordinators, yourself and Mr. Ivor Rensford, for your dedication to our graduating class by ensuring that this course was efficiently and smoothly executed. Heartfelt gratitude goes out to all the lecturers. I can't even begin naming everyone because I'd be here for a very long time. You know who you are, so I convey deepest appreciation for your dedication and hard work. We, as a graduating class, are prepared to move on and take on whatever challenges that may arise. Fellow graduates, I want you to know what a great gift it is to be as prepared as we are, because not all officers were offered such an opportunity. Here, we have had a high degree of academic excellence, and whether we intend to make a career at the Customs and Excise Department or not, we will benefit from what we've learned here. We are now set to begin the next chapter in our books. Our books will veer from the outline we created, for therein lies the beauty of our journey. This course has instilled in us a tremendous passion that can assist us in enhancing the Customs and Excise Department. We owe it to each other, our family, our lecturers, our management, our country, and our God to pursue our wireless dreams. And classmates have certainly pushed us to the brink for 8 weeks, and for this gesture we are grateful. Graduation is one of those awkward times in our lives when we are torn between the joy of our memories and the excitement of our future. Should we look back on what was one of the most thrilling 8 weeks of our lives? Times filled with joy, the aroma of the refreshments that we were provided with each day, or the eagerness of learning something new? Or instead, should we focus on our next stage in the organization? We've been impatiently waiting for this day, and now we just want to hit pause. We want to slow it down and enjoy these last fleeting moments. On a personal note, it is a great honor to have been given the opportunity to speak on behalf of the graduating class of 2018. I have been working at the Customs Department for over 3 years. I am employed under the People's Empowerment Program that has transitioned into the Skills Training Empowerment Program. Therefore, I will forever be grateful to have had the privilege to participate in this course. When I found out that I had been selected, I was excited but at the same time a little nervous of the new reality. I was prepared to learn, explore, and make new friends. The pleasant experiences that I received, of course, does not imply that I did not face my share of discomfort and challenge. It was those challenges that has made me a stronger and more confident person today. Every little encounter and experience gained here has been enriching and will remain within my memories. Be it taking a part in group projects such as vessel and container search, border security debates, or the situation refusion role plays. As a group, we gained a great amount of knowledge from topics such as communication, valuation, drug identification, and integrity, along with other interesting topics. Speaking from a graduate's perspective, I believe the stories and memories created have been equally helpful to the graduates. Everyone here has had their own share of excitement and stories that he or she will carry along his or her life. We started this course 8 weeks ago with different backgrounds and have worked in different stations and different islands. 8 weeks later, we leave this course as a collective unit. We are the pro class of 2018, no matter the stations nor the islands we came from. We are all members of the Customs and Excise Department. Fellow graduates, as we depart to our various tangents, Equipped with this wealth of knowledge, I encourage us to use this exposure as an impetus to move on to better and greater endeavors. May we be empowered by Martin Luther King Jr., who cautioned, and I quote, "If you cannot fly, then run. If you cannot run, then walk. If you cannot walk, then crawl. But by all means, keep moving. God bless."
One of our bosses outside of the Customs Department, who always finds himself giving the keynote address, I don't know why. Let's welcome Deputy Financial Secretary, Mr. Calvin Edwards.
Please let me adopt the protocol already established. It seems like just yesterday we launched this course. And when you heard 8 weeks, it was frightening. But now, today marks the end of the 12th edition of the Caribbean Customs Law Enforcement Junior Officers course, in which we had 28 junior customs officers participating, 20 from St. Kitts, 6 from Nevis, and 2 from Montserrat. So we said that this course was delivered over an 8-week period, and based on the myriad of topics covered, must have been a very intense course for all the participants. All the participants from previous courses always complain about the grueling times that they had, sleepless nights and so on. But this is the price that you have to pay for success. Success comes from sacrifice. And I'm sure today you're reaping the rewards of the sacrifices that you have made in improving yourself. I take the opportunity to thank you, the participants, for your hard work and for persevering. Persevering, because perseverance is one of the values that we have to learn in order to succeed. And I'm sure that you would agree with me that your sacrifice has paid off. I also want to thank the Comptroller of Customs and his team, especially Ms. Phipps and Mr. Butler and Mr. Rensford, who head the training unit, for all the arrangements that you have put in place in order to ensure that this training course was successfully delivered. Now, one of the unique features of this course that deserves our applause is that all the facilitators were our own people. Largely coming from the customs and other government agencies, including the Ministry of Trade, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and the Ministry of Agriculture. And this is a model that other government ministries and departments are to follow. We mentioned before that the role of the customs officer is constantly changing. Although revenue collection is still a primary function of the customs, more and more focus is being directed to border protection, money laundering, and the like. More specifically, drug and weapon interdiction have become common functions of a customs officer. In order to deal with these emerging areas, the customs officers on the front line must be equipped with particular skill sets and the basic tools to allow them to function effectively and efficiently. So this is what this training course was designed to do. Some of the core topics that were addressed related to revenue collection and being from the Ministry of Finance, that is something dear to our hearts, revenue collection. So these include legislation, tariff, valuation, and integrity. Because I understand that a misclassification could lead to a loss in revenue, big loss in revenue. So it's very important that these transactions be classified properly and valuations be done in a proper manner also to ensure that that we extract the revenue that ought to be extracted, and integrity. Customs officers mustn't view themselves as just collectors of revenue. but they must view themselves as being involved in national development. Because the revenue that comes in from the customs, that is the revenue that is used to do all the things that we want done in education, health, roads and so on, schools. Those, you help to bring in the revenue to do all of these things. So your job is not just going up there and collecting some money. It is part of the whole process of national development. Now, this was mentioned before. One of the main ingredients that must be incorporated in your life is integrity. Okay. This is what makes you do the right thing when nobody is watching. You know, sometimes people, we have values, and values are things that do not change. There are some people, they do something here in St. Kitts, and when they go to New York, they change. So that was not a value. That was something that was imposed upon you by social pressure. But a value must be something that is dear to your heart and incorporated in your life. So lack of integrity not only affects you, the customs officer, but leads to reputational damage of the customs department. And you have experienced that in the past, where one customs officer might do something that is out of the way, and then the whole customs department is branded. And you know that people like to brand the customs department because, just like in Bible days, people did not like tax collectors. And so they always seem to rejoice when one officer is involved in something that is not good. And so you have to be aware that your influence is determined by your integrity. No matter how much knowledge you have here, and you have would have gathered, you might be skilled in various areas, but if you don't have integrity, then you don't have no influence. And so the customs, your own colleagues don't respect you, and the public doesn't respect you. So when you're discharging your functions, you have to bear in mind it's not only you alone. You are representing the department, you are representing your colleagues, and you ought not to do anything that is going to compromise your department and your colleagues. So you have to bear that in mind. So all of us in our various fields must have a moral compass. And the moral compass then is a set of values that guide everything that you do. Now some people don't have any moral compass. So they do anything, anytime, any place. But once you have these incorporated within you, it helps to stabilize you and help you to resist temptation. And the temptation as a customs officer, the temptations are great because criminals have a lot of money and they would entice you into accepting or turning your head the other way in order to get some monetary reward. But as you know, those things are not very, don't last very long. And so I would encourage you to start off your career as a customs officer by incorporating a high level of integrity in what you do. So you have received a lot of information during this course. And as I think Mr. Butler said, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. And so you're expected now to go out and apply these principles in your daily job, your daily work. You have embarked on a professional career as a customs officer. And you have been given the tools and the basic tools to enable you to do a good job. So what you have to do now is to go back to your job determined to be the best customs officer possible. Go back to your jobs determined to distinguish yourself. Just like how you have a Nike, and you have Adidas, and then you have a no-name brand. Make sure you brand yourself to be a Nike. And so, I would encourage you, you have embarked on a very fundamental, a basic course which you ought now to build on. And I'm sure that there will be several opportunities for you to build on that, because I think the high priority of the customs is training. And training is necessary because globally things are changing. Every day you hear something changing, some new law, some new rule. And the global situation is that it's harmonized rules. And the job is very difficult because you want to facilitate trade, but at the same time, protect the borders. And sometimes they run contrary to one another. And so I want to encourage you to go out and do your best, because in doing so, you have a unique opportunity to contribute, to make a contribution to the development of the Federation. Thank you very much.
The moment that you've been waiting for, and this is the evidence of your hard work. You've completed and successfully completed the cyclic course, class of 2018. As your name is called, you come forward and receive your certificate. Officer Sydney Allen, Mountstrap Customs. If you hear this message, Mr. Malik Boone, St. Kitts Customs. Woman, calling every man, we're the generation. Officer Tenacia Brown. The future started yesterday, and we're already late. Officer Javon Brooks. We've been looking for a song to sing, we search for a melody, search for someone to lead. Officer Shirika Chapman, Navy's Division. For the world to change. Same, then go on and say, Officer Shakia Child, St. Kitts. Sing along with me if you're out there. Officer Tafari DeCosta, St. Kitts. Stand up and say it loud. Officer Quay St. Edward, St. Kitts. Officer Derek Francis, St. Kitts. No more. Officer Zefton Francis. No more war, less is love and peace that we're really fighting for. We can destroy hunger. Officer Andele Golden. Put down the arms and raise your voice. We're joining hands today. Officer Darren James. Officer and soldier Sidona Johnson Henderson. And by way of information, Officer Delroy Liber. Officer Lindisa Liber. Tomorrow starting now. Officer Shomari Liber. Officer Huisa Martin, Nevis Division. Officer Vander Martin. Officer Karita Pemberton. Your valedictorian, Officer Peaches Powell. Officer Dino Richards, Nevis Division. Stand up and say it loud if you're out there. Officer Daniel Romeo Monster at Custer. Officer Asiya Martin Nevis Division. Officer Claricia Somerset St. Kitts.
I'm calling every woman, calling every man.
Officer Joshua Taylor St. Kitts.
The future started yesterday, and we're already late.
Officer Liana Webb St. Kitts.
Search for a melody, search for someone to lead. We've been looking for the world to change. You feel
last,
safe,
but by no means least, Officer Tishina Williams.
Sing along with me if you're out there. I'm dying to believe that you're out there. Stand up and say it loud.